The builds never stop in the workshop. This is Atlantis reissue of the Ravel B-25 Mitchell bomber in 1/64th scale, made up of 55 parts with just over a foot wide wingspan. This was built in the cool box scale and it will fit perfect on your shelf. Let's take a look at all the parts that are in the box. I like the ones that are in this size range because you can easily put them on any shelf and you don't need a 10 foot space in the workshop to store them. We got the nice clear glass parts here. We got the framing on the glass that is prominent on the inside, or you could take a green pen of some sort or whatever color you're going to be painting it and highlight those, or you can mask it all off. We've got our little domes there. Those are lovely, our little gunner's domes in this plastic bag so I don't damage it. Is a beautiful base, something we haven't seen in a long time with this kit. Molded in clear with that world map on it, so we can suspend that above the table on its beautiful base. I don't know how many of these kits I must have picked up from Kmart back in the day in the old Ravel packaging, and they never had that stand in them, so that is pretty awesome. Atlantis picked up all these molds and is getting on with getting us these cool kits. Now, that's all 55 plastic parts, aside from the stand and the glass that we just showed. We got some nice panel line detail. Remember that this kit is older than your grandfather in many cases, so do not try to compare it to a modern kit and go, well, actually, it doesn't work that way, folks. These are nostalgia builds, short builds that you can detail up all you'd like and have an awesome time. We'll show you the interior there. Rudimentary, no interior detail because you can't see inside of it anyways, so why pay for it? We got the giant wheels and tires on this thing. We got the beautiful props, both of them there. We got our tail fins. We got our elevator back there. Those look lovely. Lovely detail on both sides. Now, I don't think I ever completed one of these as a kid. I just bought them, started on them, and then was too unskilled to get it together. We are going to be finishing this one. You can see the upper and lower wing panels with their large keys that slot into the fuselage. I'm going to build as absolute much of this as I can before I get it into paint, as always. We've got our other fuselage half, and then we'll be painting it up and decaling it with the awesome decals you'll see in a moment. But it's got very nice detail on it for being the age that it is. Nothing to sniff at, nothing to turn your nose up about. It's a nice looking kit, and we're gonna hope that it builds up well. We've got different cowlings, lower noses. We've even got two pilot figures and a nose gunner figure. We'll be able to paint those up and slide them in. And then we've got part of our, is that the nose? Or I think that's a part of an engine right there. See, I'm not a plane expert. You know what's cool about model kits? You don't have to be. We've got this awesome decal kit for two representations. This is for the base, check that out. All right, we've got the flying dragon. And we got Doolittle Raider over here. So you can do either one. We'll decide which one I want to do as soon as I soak these parts in some simple green to degrease them, and we'll be back with some sub-assemblies. What you see in front of you is not a complete sub-assembly show-off. It is a partial, and the reason is, being an airplane, we have to do some steps of painting before we can start actually gluing the fuselage together and getting the wings on. I've got the two pilot figures here. They look nice. I've got the front gunner, the nose gunner there, he is fine. I need to get them in black primer, and then I will be hand painting with craft paints all three of those guys, along with the flight deck, along with the guns and the turrets and the decks for the turrets themselves and the nose. And the reason I need to do that is I need to get those inside the fuselage before I glue the fuselage together. I need to get my turret up here and down here ready, and then what I can do is I can glue that fuselage together once I have the pilots and the cockpit inside the nose and inside the top of the cockpit there. Now, as you can see, this is just being held together by my fingers. That's a beautiful join for a mold like this, and for a kit of this price point, that is absolutely delightful. Not going to give me any problems. In fact, after I get that pinched together and glued, I'm not going to work on any of those seams. I don't want to be rescribing panel lines on a fun, quick build like this. Why bother? Why worry about it? It's going to be just fine. So we're not going to have any issues. This is where our base will be going, the ball mount for the base. So we want to leave that there so that it is balanced, of course. But when we pop that fuselage apart, what I'll do is from here forward, I will be spraying a zinc chromate or hand brushing it. That color that they ask for the interior of the aircraft. Then I will be painting the cockpit base a zinc chromate, highlighting the dash gauges just a little bit on the instrument panel and not worrying about it. So, and then I'll be hand painting the pilot figures once I get them painted. I have assembled the wings and the engines, and those went together lovely. Look at the knife edge seams on there. We're not seeing any big gaps. We're not seeing any problems on the wing tips. We're not seeing any problems on the engines where they go along. I mean, it all goes together really nice. Now, with the engines, they say you can put a hub on the back of the propeller shaft so that you can still play with the propeller. And that's fine. If you want to do it that way and you put your prop in, you attach your hub after painting everything and all that, that's fine. How I want to do it, I'm not going to be playing with it, so. And I don't care if the props spin or not when I'm done. I went ahead and glued the engine on so that when I start painting, I can get my underneath gray panels, my upper green panels all in one. I can get this all painted in one unit. I can reach in there with a brush, paint it metallic, black wash it, then paint my prop, then put a little drop on the prop shaft, shove it in, and it'll stay there forever and look absolutely wonderful. So that's not a problem at all. This wing goes together lovely too. The wingtip looks a little bunged up because I got glue on my thumb and grabbed it. If you ever get that, take glue, rub it over your thumbprint again, and let it dry, and most of it will disappear. We won't really notice much. Anything else we will call a little bit of wingtip damage coming out of the hangar, so we're not going to worry about that. When I got the fuselage together by finger strength, it just lines up with its holes and snaps together. I did test fit the tail fin, and that seems to pop right in and not have a problem. So you can see that that fits nicely. The rudders on the ends fit on nice and tight. You can see, no problems. So all I'm gonna do now, before I go any further, is get the inside fuselage parts painted and installed in half the fuselage. Then I'll close that up. Before I close it up, I'll let you guys have a look. I'll be right back. If you read into the manual, it will give you the color callouts for everybody in the cockpit and in the gunner's nose. So I painted those up with craft paints, just use the colors as listed in the manual. And these little itty bitty guys look pretty darn good. Given their age, you can even see some facial details on them. Painted them a little different per the manual's instructions. We got the nose gunner there. He's looking pretty awesome, ready to sit down. So those guys are ready, and I sealed them with a matte clear. Those will be one of the last things that go on aside from the canopies. The canopies, I used a green gel marker. That was the closest color I could get, and roughly got all of those cross marks, all of the braces for the canopy. Got all of those done, and at least they're not going to be left clear. They'll look pretty nice hanging underneath the ship. So those look good enough for me. Those will be fine to snap in. We've got the gunner's platform painted in the recommended zinc chromate that they say in the nose. We've got the interior painted in that zinc chromate so you can see it through all that glass coming down. And then I painted up the cockpit. You can see right there. We'll try to angle it up. You can see that it is painted. What I did was I painted that black, and then I gently rubbed it with a silver pencil. It doesn't matter the brand, guys, just a silver pencil. Just gently rub it, and it'll bring out the little detail, and the pilots and everything will be sitting on there. So what I have to do now is just take those two halves and clip them together, and then we'll glue them. We'll clamp that and let all that glue dry. We'll put our nose piece on. We'll put our nose piece on like so. We'll use model glue. We'll get that all together. Then I'll put the tails and the wings on and get all the whole thing all glued up aside from putting the props in and the landing gear. We'll get all this glued in. I prefer to do it that way. Then I'll be able to mask and do the two-tone, the gray underneath and the green on top. So I will come back when this is all glued together so we can actually get a look at the cool size of this B-25. It's paint time on the build. We've got the assembly of the fuselage all set up. Of course, being green olive drab plastic, if you do use model glue on it and you're going to be painting it and everything, it does tend to look kind of horrorish. Looks dreadful as well how it looks. But we've got everything glued together here. I've got one piece of tape left holding that tail fin on and a straight up and down, so that I know it's there. In about 10 minutes, I'll pull that last piece off and it'll be just as rock solid as the other one. But we've got it all together. Just have to stuff some cotton balls in the front of the fuselage so I don't paint that. The pilots and the gunner and all that will be installed later. I can do all that later. So we've got all that set up. We got the wings on. There were minor gaps where the wings reached the fuselage, so I let the model glue dry to melt them together. Then I filled those gaps with some cheap gel super glue from the dollar store. I just squirt it in, and then I use a Q-tip to smooth it out, and it's more than good enough for me on this model. I have not joined the turrets permanently to the hull or anything like that because of the fact that I just want to slide them in at the end. I'm going to be gluing them into position so I don't need to have them turning, so that I can do all separately. Same with the glass and everything. We're going to do that all very last. After we put the pilots in, we'll be able to push the turret on, drop a CA glue, it'll hold it tight, and we'll be all set. I also made sure to attach the ball mount to the bottom, glue that in tight so I get it painted with the entire rest of the airframe. What I'll be doing for the paint is shooting the props and the fuselage and the landing gear and the landing gear doors all with black to begin with. Then I'll flip the whole plane over and I will give it a coat of gray. They want light gray on the bottom and along the sides. So we'll be doing gray primer all along the bottom and up the sides of the fuselage that you can see from the bottom. Then I will be going and masking an irregular pattern along the bottom. Just do whatever you want. Just an irregular pattern. Can be wavy, small waves, big waves, it doesn't matter. And along the bottom of the engines. And then once we get that all masked, I will be doing my final darker green color and whatnot. We'll come back once I get all that stuff painted. I'll take it over to the paint area and let you see me shoot the color on it.
Oh.
With the primary painting of the fuselage and wings and everything done, now I can move on to doing some light masking. What I like to use is washi tape, W-A-S-H-I, find it at any craft store in giant tubes full of these rolls. It's a nice thin tape. You can see that it presses down lovely into the seams and everything. I need to do the flat black coating on the front of the wings. I'm assuming that's for anti-icing reasons. It also has them on the tail fins, so we need to mask those off, and I've done so top and bottom. All I'm going to do now is take some lovely little craft paint and with the masking on there, lightly hand brush it on to all those areas carefully, and that'll look awesome. This is old school type modeling. We don't have to get super precise. Neither is the kit itself. We've got that awesome double color with the light gray on the bottom and the green on top with those wavy lines. Also made sure to do the engines that way. Once I get those black anti-icing strips, is what I'm going to call them, done, I'm going to go in and paint metallic inside the engine. I will touch up anything I need to touch up in the cockpit area. I will then attach my figures. I have to paint my wheel center silver. I've got the props ready to go. What I have to do with those now that they're black is do the yellow tips and the red spinner. I'm just basing this off the box art and the everything on there. So I will get those yellow tips in. I might still spray those by masking them off real quick. I'm not sure, but the tips I will easily do by hand. Won't be hard at all. The landing gear is painted. Now I will cut those free from the tree, take this back over to the paint area, and fix these front landing gear doors to get those fuselage color and then hand paint zinc oxide green on the bottom like they request. So not a massive amount of work done. Once I get all the guys inside the cockpit, get the engines painted, get these strips painted, we'll come back for another look-see. Now with all my detail painting done all around the aircraft, I did some very light weathering over the top of the engines with just using some graphite rubbed on a makeup sponge. And we got that all done there to make it look like the engines have belched out a little bit of oil over the missions, but not really filthy it up. I went and gave the airplane a nice gloss coat, got the pilots in there, made sure everything was painted zinc chromate on the inside, got the pilots glued in. It's starting to look pretty good. The reason I went with the gloss coat is, of course, because I have to apply all these cool decals. And over a flat coat, a lot of times if they don't want to settle down over a dull coat, they will silver, which means they will show that rough texture underneath them. So we gave it a nice gloss. We're ready to go. There are very few decals to apply. I have attached the bottoms of the turrets, and once we're all done, and I know I won't be breaking things off, the turrets will start to get snapped on and glued into place. I've also got to do the cockpit doors and attach the landing gear. This is going to be using the clear stand. I definitely want to do the in-flight stand for it. I'm not going to paint it. I like the idea of the box art of just placing that North American B-25 logo right over the center there and leaving that stand alone. The reason I could do the doors closed and have it be in flight, or you can do it with the gear down, which gives you a little more detail on the aircraft with this nice looking landing gear here. And it could be just taking off or approaching landing. We don't know. But the black paint on the front of the wings came out just fine. Masking it and hand painting it. It says it does have a black tail cone, so I made sure to paint that. Then sealed it with that clear. That'll keep that craft paint from rubbing and chipping off real easy. I also did the engines. You can see them. They do have a little more detail than you'd think once you get some paint on them. And then did a mild black wash with Tamiya panel line accent color inside there, just to give them a little bit of a detail. They're going to look stellar with the stellar with the propellers in front of them. Propellers were painted to match the box art with a red nose cone and yellow tips. Those look lovely, and those will go in there and be glued in place. I won't worry about them spinning later. So we're going to get all that attached. I haven't done anything with the nose cone yet because our nose gunner does sit with that machine gun sticking out of the nose, and I know turning it over and putting decals on, I'm going to break that off. So we're going to leave that alone. When I get all this together with the decals on, let those dry, I'm going to hit it with a matte finish, a flat finish. Then I will attach the glass, the cockpit glass, and the turrets and everything so that I don't cloud those up before we're all done. I'll be back in just a moment. There she goes, round and round. Atlantis 164th scale B-25 Mitchell bomber is all done. And what a beautiful, nostalgic build. The kit still goes together. I think this thing's been out since the 50s. I know that I had a copy in the 80s. Didn't do anywhere near as nice a job as this. Botched it up pretty good. Probably never got it finished. But man, this is so fun to build now when you have a little bit more skill underneath your belt. And this will go together so easy. The nice thing is it's molded all in green. So even if you wanted to get this for the kiddos, they could easily push and glue this together as an airplane kit for any age. It would be absolutely fine. And then the adults in us can give it a little more detail and a little more pizzazz like I've gone ahead and done here. Everything went together lovely. Didn't have to sit and shave parts forever to get them to fit. You saw the fuselage pressed together. You saw the wings push in. Just used a little super glue. Some of the products that I used on this review, one of the glues I used to hold the figures inside the canopy is this cheap glue from the dollar store right next to the super glue. Fix all adhesive. The reason I used that was when I put the figures in and the guns behind the glass, I didn't want, after I sealed the glass on, for the super glue to gas out and it would have clouded everything up. All that beautiful glass work on there, so I wanted to leave that alone. Using a glue like this will not vent out, will not ruin. Also, some attachment points were done with super glue. When I filled the gaps in there, I used a thicker version, putting the props on, stuff like that, putting the landing gear in place, putting the landing gear doors in place. Cheap super glue from the dollar store, buck a piece. They last forever. The interior was done with Model Master acrylic zinc chromate. That works well. A lot of the masking, as you saw, was done with washi tape, available at any craft store like Hobby Lobby. Also, for the weathering on the engines, dollar store makeup, charcoal and brown, a buck a piece. Use the little foam applicators to apply it, and that goes on real easy for your weathering. We used Mod Podge, put on with a paintbrush, just dipped into the Mod Podge and painted on anywhere I had to attach a final clear part so there'd be no clouding. And inside those engines, as we talked about, Tamiya Panaline accent color. The rest of the paints and details were shown during the other parts of the build. Everything went together so lovely. The decals sit down perfectly. Put a little bit of decal solvent on them, and they sucked right into the rivets and everything on the airframe and look absolutely wonderful. And then I coated the whole airplane with a coat of flat. Then I applied the final glass pieces. You can see the turret in the top, turret in the bottom, the observation bulge, the antenna, the glass and everything. Looks absolutely awesome. And I did the little red tips on the propeller spinners, just like they did. I did not paint the base. I put that cool decal on there. I think that looks absolutely excellent, just the way it is. You could do it without the landing gear. Close the landing gear doors and have it in flight. This is in flight as if he just took off or is coming in for a landing. I like that landing gear on there, so I wanted to use all the stuff that was in the box available to me. You can see how easy it was to do a two-tone paint job on there with the upper and lower fuselage. Everything was a joy. Can't wait to get more vintage kits from Atlantis. They got some really cool stuff coming out, and I'm going to try to build every single one of them. We will see you at the next review.